JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for August the 25th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded somewhat lower against the majority of the other regional currencies on Monday and during the Asian morning Tuesday. It gained against CAD, JPY and NZD, while it underperformed versus NOK, the Euro, the Pound, SEC, the Swiss franc and the Aussie in that order. Now, the weakening of the dollar and the yen suggests that the financial world traded in a risk-on fashion, but the relative strength of the franc and the slide in the kiwi points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU and US indices were a sea of green, with the Nasdaq and the S&P 500 hitting new records. The optimism rolled somewhat over the Asian session today as well, although China's Shanghai Composite and Hong Kong's Hang Seng are down 0.30 and 0.31% respectively. Japan's Nikkei and South Korea's KOSPI are up 1.34% and 1.58%. Now, the main catalyst behind the boost in investors' morale may have been signs of progress in developing a coronavirus vaccine. On Sunday, the US Food and Drug Administration authorized the use of plasma from recovered patients as a treatment option, while the Financial Times reported that the Trump administration is considering fast-tracking the vaccine being developed by AstraZeneca as the company marked further progress. Overnight reports that top US and Chinese officials see progress being made in resolving concerns over the Phase 1 trade accord may have also helped the broader appetite. It seems that investors are still ignoring that the virus continues to spread fast around the globe. Lately, Europe has seen an acceleration in infected cases, and still EU shares rose on average 2.08% yesterday. Perhaps the market believes that we have more cases due to more tests being conducted, or it may be looking at the better situation in terms of hospitalization and death toll. What may have also taken a backseat is the fact that in the US, Republicans and Democrats remain deadlocked over a new coronavirus aid bill. Now, looking ahead, the next event that could attract investor attention is the Kansas City Fed Jackson Hole Economic Symposium, which will be held virtually this time due to the pandemic. The conference is scheduled for Thursday and Friday. Following the blurry picture the Fed minutes painted last week in terms of the committee's future plans, investors could lock their gaze on Fed Chair Powell's keynote speech on Thursday, looking for clues as to whether more stimulus will be introduced soon, and if so, what form it may take. Market chatter also suggests that Powell may address the future approach to the inflation target, allowing consumer prices to overshoot it in order to make up for the years of undershooting. Now, as for today's events, and during the early European morning, we already got Norway's GDP for the second quarter. The headline quarter-over-quarter rate slid to -5.1% from -1.7%, while the mainland one fell to -6.3% from -2.2%, missing slightly estimates of -6.1%. Bearing in mind that in Norges Bank's June quarterly report, the forecast for the second quarter mainland GDP was -6.1%. We don't expect a -6.3% quarter-over-quarter contraction to alter the plans of Norges Bank officials for staying sidelined for a while more. After all, that may have been the reason for NOK's modest reaction at the time of the release. From Germany, we have the IFO survey for August. Both the current assessment and expectations indices are expected to have risen to 87 and 98 from 84.5 and 97 respectively, something that will drive the business climate index up to 92 from 90.5. Having said that though, bearing in mind that the current conditions index of the ZEW survey slid further into the negative territory instead of rebounding as the forecast suggested, we would consider the risks surrounding the IFO current assessment index as tilted to the downside. With the number of infected cases in Europe accelerating lately, while at the same time cases in the US have started to slow somewhat, and deteriorating view with regards to Germany's current economic condition will not come as a surprise to us, although this could hurt the euro somewhat. The nation's final GDP for the second quarter is also coming out, which is expected to confirm the preliminary estimate that the eurozone's economic powerhouse has contracted 10.1% quarter over quarter. Later in the day, we have from the US, we have the Conference Board Consumer Confidence Index for August and the new home sales for July. The CMB index is expected to have risen fractionally to 93 from 92.6, while new home sales are anticipated to have slowed to 1.3% month over month from 13.8%. The American Petroleum Institute weekly report on crude oil inventories is also coming out, but as it is always the case, no forecast is currently available. We also have two speakers on today's agenda, San Francisco Fed President Marin Daly and Bank of Canada Governing Council member Lawrence Chabry. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm hosting every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.